Welcome to our official HKB YouTube channel. I'm Sifu Lin, and today I will be teaching about our HKB Wing Chun punches.
In the entire HKB Wing Chun system, is all based on the idea of maximum efficiency. We are talking about the maximum efficiency of time, space, and energy. So in today's lesson, I will show you how to apply the maximum efficiency using our basic punch, which is the first punch that you learn in your first lesson. It's called the yin punch. Now, by definition, maximum efficiency means whatever you're doing can no longer be simplified into less steps. So let's say if you have to do 2 steps or 3 steps to stop an attack, and it can be simplified into less steps, therefore it's not maximum efficiency. And we believe what makes Wing Chun Wing Chun is actually the maximum efficiency, not because the look or the style or the technique or the movement. In today's lesson, assisting me is my two instructor from the HKB headquarters in Tustin, California, Ando and Michael Koo. So before I demonstrate our basic yin punch, I want to explain a little bit about the mechanics behind it. So in an HKB Wing Chun, in order to have maximum efficiency, we have to use our basic guideline, what we call the formula, which will dictate certain position of your body parts, from hands to elbow, knees to foot. So the physical movement of our yin punch actually looks like this with the punch. As you can see, with the elbow is actually on the inside based on the formula, following the yin line, and then the other hand is actually on the upper reference point, and with the guarding and up, and the fists actually have to be located in the center. This is what looks like in the front. Now from the side, it looks like this. From the other side, it looks like this. So the whole idea about Wing Chun, in general, you know, it's basically many people see Wing Chun as simultaneously attack and defend at the same time. In other words, using offense sometimes as defense, which what we believe is the best type of defense. Now, so in our system, there is a term what we call occupying time and becoming space. Occupying time means you're also attacking the opponent as they attack you at the same time, okay? The only problem with that is that, you know, if you just attack, so for example, if the opponent punch you, and you also punch the opponent at the same time, okay, then one of you is gonna get hit, if not both, depending who's longer and faster. All right, this is what we call the luck factor. Instead, instead of extending the hand like a typical punch, what we do is we bring the elbow inside on the yin line and put the hands on the center, and the hands like this. So with that being said, as the punch coming in, you know, when my elbow is actually following the basic guidelines of the formula, it gives me the ability to occupy his time and becoming space, meaning I can attack him, but he cannot attack me in the same time. Now, speaking of becoming space, I want to talk a little bit more about it. Obviously, when you talk about space, there's many different ways to deal with the space. One is blocking. Second is occupying space. Third is becoming space, okay? We already clear about occupying the time, so meaning you're attacking in the same time. So let's get that out of the way. Now let's talk about the space part. Blocking the space means, you know, you're moving through a one-dimensional factor, okay? So the only problem with that is you would lose the efficiency. Why? Because as I mentioned earlier, the definition of maximum efficiency, whatever you're doing can no longer be simplified into less steps to make it more efficient, right? So that means if your attempt can be simplified into less steps,
you lost the efficiency. So for example, if you punch, if I block this way, this is what we call one directional. As you can see, my energy is going that way. So in order for me to launch the neck attack is I have to use the second step, which is either this hand or I have to switch with the other hand and so forth. Okay, in that case, it would take me a two step where it can be simplified into less step. Okay, the second is what we call occupying the space. Occupying the space, instead of just an X factor, as X factor, we're gonna do X and Y. Sometimes this is many other Wing Chun recognize this as cutting through the center line, which is looks like this punch. This is cut through the center line. The only problem with this, you know, if the opponent is not that strong, it's fine. Okay, as long as you have a good structure, you can destroy his structure. Problem is, if his structure is very strong, and what you're trying to do is to cut the X and the Y, then what would happen is it will be force against force. If you're not strong enough, when you try to cut, it will punch. Unless you have to use, you have to have a super, super strong structure to collapse the structure. But this, with that being said, when you use force against force, that's breaking the idea of maximum efficiency, in this case of energy. Now the last one is what we call becoming the space. Now when you use becoming the space, in that sense, you maintain the efficiency of time because you attack in the same time, the efficient space, so no wasted movement, and with the least amount of energy, the most efficient way of energy. So even if his arm is actually very strong, all right, where if I just cut X and Y, it's gonna be difficult. Now on the third one, you know, the difference is I'm gonna have the X, the Y, and the Z, which is the width, the length, and the height. So even with the slight force, okay, I'm not even gonna clench my fist, so it's just very, very loose. With a slight tap, see how easy to actually control his actual space. And in the same time, I'm still attacking him. So this is what we call maximum efficiency. So enough of the explanation. So let us show you how it's being done. So go ahead, guys. So on a side note, I want to cover a very important topic here. When you train the HKB Wing Chun, just be sure you're doing Wing Chun as a system, not a style. Okay? What makes, from our perspective, what makes Wing Chun Wing Chun is not because of the look or this technique or that movement. Okay? It's actually because the idea of maximum efficiency of time, space, energy as a system. What I mean by that, you know, because you know, our punch look like this, that's what makes Wing Chun to be Wing Chun, or vice versa. What makes Wing Chun to be Wing Chun is not because the look like this, it's because of the function of the efficiency. So for example, let's say if I'm using this movement as a Wing Chun, I can apply in the wrong way as a style would be like this punch. Even though I might be doing it fast, but as you can see, the movement actually take two steps. Going down will be like a pop and then a punch, which is technically a two step. Now, anything that can be simplified is not maximum efficiency. So if I'm doing a Wing Chun as a style, then I lost the idea of the efficiency, therefore it's not Wing Chun. Instead, if I do something like this, punch,
my movement just one, and I can no longer simplify that one movement. Therefore, this is maximum efficiency. And this is what we believe to make Wing Chun.
So that's it for today, guys. You know, don't forget to watch the next video next week, same time, will be uploaded. So on the behalf of HKP Wing Chun, I want to thank you for watching our channel.